Hi students, let us discuss about the ear. Student, ear is the stereoacoustic receptor. It has reception for two senses, hearing and equilibrium. Student, this is the diagram that showing the parts of the ear. It is the pinna and external auditory meatus and this is the part of the middle ear and this is the part inner ear. Student, it is Eustachian tube. Student, entire the part of the ear divides into three regions: external ear, middle ear, inner ear. Student, what about the external ear? External ear, that is with the three parts. Students, these are pinna, external auditory meatus and the eardrum. Pinna, what about the pinna? Student, pinna, it is the outer ear. It is the outer portion of the external ear. Student, and it is covered with the skin. Pinna is covered with the skin. And elastic membrane present in the pinna. It receives sound waves from the outer surrounding areas. Student, next another external auditory meatus. It passes the sound waves into the part of the eardrum or the tympanum. Student, it is the tympanum. External auditory meatus, just it is a straight and curved tube like arrangement. And eardrum, it is ends at the eardrum. Student, it is the eardrum. It is also called tympanum. It is the first time formed in the amphibians. Next, eardrum, it is a thin semi-transparent portion between the external auditory meatus and the middle ear. Student, it is the tympanum or the eardrum. Okay. And it separates the external artery meters with the parts of the middle ear. Student, next another, it is composed by the eardrum or the tympanum is composed with the connective tissue and covers with the skin. Student, and another, mucous membrane is also present in it and covered with the air. Covered with the air. Entire the part of the external ear, a pinna and external auditory meatus, curved tube like arrangement. It is the entire the part is covered with the air and also having wax secreting sebaceous glands, which are called ceruminous glands. Students, the parts of the external ear is covered with the air and also consist wax secreting sebaceous glands, which are called ceruminous gland, secrete ceramin. This is the arrangement prevents the entry of the dust particles into the ear. Next, another one, what about the middle ear? Middle ear, it is a air-filled cavity, air-filled space, and it locates at the region of the temporal bone. And middle ear, that is between the eardrum and bony partition, that contain two openings, oval window and round window. Student, middle ear, at the end region of the middle ear, that consists two window-like arrangement. Okay, these are, one is the oval window and the one is the round window. Student, by the help of the oval window, middle ear is opens into the inner ear. Student, this is the middle ear, that is the region present between the tympanum or eardrum and bony partition, that contains two opening. One is the oval window and the other one is the round window. Student, also middle ear, that consists of three ear ossicles. Okay, these are the ear ossicles arranged in a chain like manner in the middle ear. Ear ossicle means small bony structures present in the middle ear. Malleus, these are malleus, incus, stapes. Student, this is the malleus, this is the incus, and this is the stapes. Okay. Malleus, it is the modification of the articular, and incus, it is the modification of the quadrate, and stapes, it is modification of the iomandibulum. Student, stapes is the smallest bone in the human body. And malleus connected with the tympanic membrane. Okay, malleus connected with the tympanic membrane. This is the tympanic membrane, student. Malleus connect to it. And another, head of the malleus articulates with the incus. Head of the malleus articulates with, connected with the incus. And incus articulates with the head of the stapes. Incus articulates with the head of the stapes. And stapes attaches to the oval window finally. And what about the Eustachian tube? This is the Eustachian tube that connects the, it is the tube-like arrangement that connects the middle ear to the pharynx. Okay, student. And it helps to equalize the pressures in either sides of the eardrum. Okay, student. Either sides of the eardrum, the pressure is equalizes by the help of the Eustachian tube that connects the middle ear with the pharynx. Next, another one, inner ear. What about the inner ear? Inner ear, it is mostly fluid filled, that is the fluid filled region present in the inner ear called labyrinth. Student, labyrinth is divided into two parts, bony labyrinth and the membranous labyrinth. Student, what about the bony labyrinth? It is the region, student, with the semicircular canals and cochlea, student, cochlea. Cochlea is with the organ of Corti. Student, vestibule, these are the parts present in the inner ear. Bony labyrinth that have three parts, cochlea, first one, vestibule, semicircular canals. Student, what about the cochlea? Student, this is the cochlea, watch spring-like structure. Cochlea, watch spring-like structure. Student, three tubes present in the cochlea. Student, this is the region, this is the part that shows the section of the cochlea. Three tubes present in the cochlea, that is the scala vestibuli. Student, this is the scala vestibuli, it is the region, scala vestibuli, it is the tube like structure, scala vestibuli. Scala media, this is the center part, scala media. Scala tympani, this is the scala tympani. Student, next, another, scala vestibuli, scala media. Scala vestibuli, scala media. This is the scala vestibuli, this is the scala media. Both are separated by one of the membrane structure that is called Ricinus membrane. Student, Ricinus membrane that separates scala vestibuli with scala media. Next, and the student, basilar membrane. What about the basilar membrane? Basilar membrane separates scala media with the scala tympani. Student, it is the scala tympani, it is the middle point, scala media. Scala media, scala tympani separates with the another membrane, that is a basilar membrane. It is the basilar membrane, it is the Ricinus membrane. Next, scala vestibuli and scala tympani. Scala vestibuli, scala tympani filled with the perilymph. Student, and another, scala media that is filled with endolymph, that is filled with endolymph. Next, scala vestibuli, it is ends at the oval window. Scala vestibuli is ends at the region of oval window. and another scala tympani ends with a round window. Next, what about the organ of Corti? Organ of Corti, it is the part of the cochlea. Next, on the basilar membrane, already you know basilar membrane. Basilar membrane that separates scala media with the scala tympani and the basilar membrane, student. Cochlear epithelium forms one of the sensory ridge-like arrangement. That is the sensory ridge-like arrangement present on the surface of the basilar membrane. Student, that is called organ of Corti. Okay, this is the organ of Corti contain hair cells which are act as a auditory receptors. Student, and under these cells are connected with the these cells present in the organ of Corti, hair cells which are act as auditory receptors are connected with the nerve fibers of the cochlear branch of 8th cranial nerve. Next, student, basal end of the hair cell close contact with the auditory nerve fiber. Next, another one, vestibule. Student, vestibule, another in this, before vestibule there is a one of the part includes in the bony labyrinth, that is a semicircular canal. Student, these are semicircular canals. These are three in number, 1, 2, 3, three in number. Semicircular canals are three in number. These are canal like arrangements. Basal part of the each canal that shows a swallow structure, these are called ampulla. Student, semicircular canals, semicircular canals involved in the sense of angular movement. Student, angular movement of the human body, for example direction movement of the body, and head moves to side. Student, these are the angular movements are perceived by, regulated by the semicircular canals. Okay, student. Next, and the what about the vestibule? Vestibule in membrane labyrinth. In membrane labyrinth, it is not in the bony labyrinth, in membrane labyrinth. Vestibule consists of three sac-like arrangement. These are called saccule and utricle. Student, saccule, utricles, these are utricle and the saccules. Student, utricle collectively it is also called otolith organ. Utricle, it is collectively also called otolith organ. Student, and under this is the part also contain one of the ridge like arrangement which is called macula. Student, macula has receptors for gravity. Student, and saccule utricle provides a sense of linear acceleration. Angular acceleration, it is controlled by semicircular canals like a rotation of the head and directional movement of the human body. Another, linear acceleration. Linear acceleration is regulated by the vestibule that consists two parts which are called utricle and the saccule. Utricle saccule provides sense of linear acceleration. Student, saccule perceives, saccules having sense for the vertical movement. Vertical movement, for example, vertical movement when you going on the lift. Student, for upward movement, downward movement is possible by the help of the saccule. And utricle that perceives horizontal movement when you going in a car. Okay, at that time movement like a forward movement and the backward movement. The type of the horizontal movement is perceived by the utricle. Student, next, semicircular canals, saccule, utricles are connected to the vestibular branch of the eighth cranial nerve. Student, vestibule that controls equilibrium state of the human body. Students, now about mechanism of hearing. Ear receives sound waves from the external area, outer area, transmitted through the external auditory meatus and reaches into the eardrum. Students, and eardrum is with the tympanic membrane and goes to the vibration. Student, and vibration, these are the vibrations related with the sound waves, transmit through ear ossicles to the oval window. Student, middle ear consists of 3 ear ossicles, small bones, malleus, incus, stapes. These are arranged in chain-like manner. Receive sound waves from the eardrum and transmit these sound waves, vibrations, in the form of the vibrations, into the inner ear by the help of the oval window. Oval window, it is the way for opening, for entry, and it is with the connective region between the middle ear into the inner ear. Student, and movement of the oval window causes wave in perilymph of vestibuli, scala vestibuli. Students, when movement is possible in the oval window, part of the oval window, this causes the waves in the perilymph. Student, perilymph, that is in the scala vestibuli. Scala vestibuli is the part of cochlea. Student, cochlea is the inner part of ear. This is the cochlea, divides into 3 tubes: scala vestibuli, scala media, scala tympani. Scala vestibuli separates with scala media by the resinous membrane. Scala media separates with the scala tympani by the basilar membrane. Student, these are the vibrations causes the waves in perilymph present in the scala vestibuli. Next, and it is also produces vibrations in endolymph of the scala media. Scala media, that is totally filled with the endolymph. At the same time, vibrations is also produced in endolymph of the scala media. And these are the vibrations induces ripples or the wave-like movement in basilar membrane. Student, basilar membrane, it separates scala media with the scala tympani. Okay, and vibrations induces ripples in basilar membrane. Student, basilar movement bend the air cells, pressing them. Student, pressing them, the tectorial membrane. Student, tectorial membrane, the cochlea is covered with the membrane structure is called tectorial membrane. Basilar membrane, that is with the airy cells which are act as auditory receptors. Okay, when vibrations induces ripples in the basilar membrane, causes basilar movement and bend the air cells. Student, and pressing them tectorial membrane, which is covers the surface of the cochlea. Tectorial membrane, that one is. Next, at the same time, nerve impulse is generated and transmitted through the auditory nerve into the auditory center, auditory part present in the brain. Student says about mechanism of the hearing.